On the coast of northeast China is a place that looks like something out of a movie, a marsh carpeted by stunning blood-red vegetation. This is China's famous Red Beach, a tourist destination that attracts more than 2 million visitors every year. The amazing color comes from ruby-hued plants called Sueda salsa, and it isn't just their color that's impressive. This plant has superpowers that could benefit wetlands around the world. Sueda salsa is a part of a genus of plants called the seepweeds. It also doesn't have a common name in English that we could find, so we're going to call it the salsa plant for fun. It's red and green, so checks out. There are over 100 different seepweed species around the world, and they're usually found in salty or alkaline wetlands. The salsa plant in particular is native to Eastern and Central Europe and Southern Siberia, as well as China, but it doesn't have the same incredible color everywhere. Plants that grow above the high tide, where conditions are drier, are tall, fluffy, and green. Lower down, in wetter, saltier habitat, they're shorter, with fleshy red-violet leaves. Scientists who've looked into this have found that plants in the two different environments react to their surroundings by ramping the expression of certain proteins up or down as a response to the stress caused by excess salt and waterlogging. One result is that the plants in the wetter, saltier habitat accumulate more red pigments in their leaves, which is what gives them their fabulous color. And at the Red Beach, freshwater, saltwater, nutrient-rich sediment delivered by the Liao River, and climate have come together in a unique way to support a vibrant carpet of those scarlet plants. But the salsa plant is interesting for way more than just its color. For one thing, it's edible, although the green kind is apparently way tastier than the famous red kind. The leaves are typically a famine food, only eaten as a last resort, but its seeds are full of healthy oils, and scientists think it has untapped potential as a food plant in areas where other crops are tough to grow. It's also the focus of intense study as a tool for restoring degraded wetlands, especially in China. Our salsa plant is a pioneer species, meaning it's one of the first plants to colonize a newly created habitat, or to recolonize habitat that's been disturbed. It can quickly establish itself in harsh, salty coastal marshes due to its high salt tolerance, and as it grows, it can actually remove harmful levels of salt from the soil. This is an extra big deal because sea level rise due to climate change means that coastal wetlands around the world are getting saltier. Molecular biologists are even studying the genes that make the salsa plant so salt tolerant, hoping to someday use them to make other species more resilient. And the salsa plant's ability to thrive in tough conditions doesn't stop with salt. It can also tolerate the presence of toxic heavy metals like copper and lead, and remove those from the soil as well. The list of good stuff that this wonder plant can do goes on and on. It sequesters carbon, locking it away out of the atmosphere. It improves the diversity and function of the soil microbe community. Basically, the salt plant can take a barren, salty, polluted coastal habitat and begin its transformation into a thriving wetland ecosystem. And folks in China are doing this. Multiple restoration projects have successfully established the salsa plant in areas contaminated by oil spills or disturbed by human activity. At first, all you would see in a restoration area is barren sediment and sand, interspersed with tiny red plants. The plants grow slowly at first, especially in contaminated soil, and they take a few years to really get going. But over time, they boost the health of the environment they're in. And as the salsa plants grow, filling in those bare areas, birds and other wildlife begin to return as well, until the site is filled with the sights and sounds of a thriving wetland. But here's the twist. Red Beach itself, the salsa plant's most famous stronghold, is under threat. But before we get into all that, let's take a quick ad break.
Thanks to our presidents of science for making this SciShow video possible. These incredible patrons help us keep the stuff you're watching right now totally free so that anyone can learn from them, because education is a human right. We make these videos to cultivate curiosity and build knowledge in more people, more ways, and more places. And the presidents of science keep that vision alive through generous donations at patreon.com/scishow. To join McLaren Stanley, Charlie Stanley, and TJ Stein in supporting all that good stuff, you can become a patron for $2 per month, or as much as you want to responsibly give. But our biggest ask of you is to just keep watching SciShow.
Red Beach is part of a state-protected nature preserve. It even includes a wooden jetty so that tourists can take in the spectacular color without trampling the plants. It's home to hundreds of wildlife species, including rare vulnerable birds like the red-crowned crane, white-naped crane, and black-faced spoonbill. But the Liao River Delta, where Red Beach is located, is threatened by development for rice paddies and aquaculture. It's also the location of one of the largest oil fields in China. All of this is affecting the salsa plant's ability to flourish in the region. Studies have found that Sueda salsa is only growing in a small fraction of the area that could theoretically support it, in part because of the conversion of wetland habitat for things like fish farms. It hasn't always been this way, but as development has advanced, the area inhabited by Sueda salsa has declined by 63% in the last 30 years. And the area may be vulnerable to climate change. After an exceptionally hot, dry summer in 2018 hit the Liao River Delta region, the plants' above-ground biomass, their leaves and stems, appeared to recover quickly, but their root systems did not. Instead, their roots continued to shrink for at least 2 years, suggesting that these plants may have a hard time fully bouncing back as extreme weather events become more frequent. So the future is uncertain. Turns out even a superplant isn't immune to all of the ways humans can mess up the natural world. And while the salsa plant may have the power to save and restore coastal wetland habitat across wide swaths of Eurasia and beyond, we may need to save them first.